If you're not quite ready to invest in a paid keyword research tool to help you come up with low competition niches and keywords for your self-published books, then stick around. I'm going to show you two free Chrome extensions from self-publishing titans that are going to help you to streamline and speed up the process of keyword research for your self-published books that you publish on the KDP platform. I'm going to show you how these tools work and how they compare to other paid and free tools that are out there for you. And I'll let you know who I think these tools are best suited for. Stick around. If you're new around here, my name is Rachel Harrison Sund, and I help people to generate passive income selling journals, planners, notebooks, and more on the Kindle Direct publishing platform. If that sounds interesting to you, then don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so that you can be notified every time I put out one of these videos, which is every Monday. All right, so before we get on to the comparison, let me know, do you use any free or paid keyword research tools when you're doing your research for self-publishing books on Amazon? Let me know in the comments below. So these are the two free Chrome extensions. We've got the KDP Research Chrome extension on the left and the KDP Keyword Expander Chrome extension on the right. So let's just go right into Amazon and take a look how we can use them. So first, I'm just going to go to the books department and let's just look at daily planners. So right now I've just got the KDP Research Chrome extension activated. I haven't turned on the Keyword Suggestion Expander just yet. I'll just take you through them one at a time here. So as you can see at the top, we've got a keyword niche score. We've got the number of results, the average price, the average bestsellers rank, average reviews, and you know, you've got their Facebook group here, which you can join. You've got an option to download all the first page data, so that's really useful. And then they've just got links to other free tools from their website and some video tutorials on how to use this. So this keyword niche score is something to take note of here. The developer of this Chrome extension says it's recommended to find niches with a score of 62% or higher. So they've created an algorithm that takes into account all the listings on the first page. And that kind of goes through, you know, how many product results there are, how many results on the first page, the prices, the average price, what all the reviews are, the average reviews, basically all the stuff that's contained in this top bar here. They're using all that information to come up with a competitive score. And like I said, they recommend choosing one with a competitive score of 62% or higher. Now, one thing I will say is a couple of these metrics, I'm not sure exactly how useful they're going to be. You know, for example, average reviews, 1,058. I think that's really, you can get some metrics here that are going to really throw you off. Like, that's probably because there's, you know, maybe one book that's got 1,000 reviews. You know, this one's got 91. A couple of these don't have any. You've got this one book, this has got to be the one that's throwing everything off with the 1,450 reviews. This one's got 357. So for me, I don't think it's enough just to look at the average reviews. I think you've kind of got to dig down deeper and look at each book individually. The other thing you can do, depending on, you know, if you want to narrow it down further, you can just click paperback, see what comes up with the results there. So we're still loading the results here. Obviously that makes a big difference. Now you're looking at 252 reviews rather than over 1,000. But again, you never want to just, you know, this kind of data can be helpful, but you never just want to look only at those numbers without using your own two eyes to just kind of scroll down and do a little bit of a comparison here. So you, again, you can see like the bulk of the reviews here are coming from this one book. So you definitely have to keep that sort of manual part of the research process going and not just rely solely on these numbers. The other helpful thing here is it's giving you information that you would have had to click into to get. So it's showing you the bestsellers rank of the book, the rank in the number one category that it's ranking for. It's showing you the ISBN and who the publisher is. So that's just going to save you a little bit of time rather than having to click individually on each book to get into that. Normally that's what you'd have to do in order to get this information. And of course, the other helpful feature that we already mentioned here is you can download all the first page data. So that's just going to give you the ASIN or the ISBN, the author of the book, and the title of the book. So that's something that just could be useful if you are, you know, trying to keep track of the names of these books. Maybe you want to use it for your keyword research or something like that. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and turn on the second Chrome extension here, the Amazon Search Suggestion Expander, which I think is probably the more useful out of the two extensions. And again, all you need to do here, just start typing in whatever it is you're looking for. And you're going to get this entire list of keywords come up. So these are all the suggested search keywords from Amazon. So you've got the primary Amazon suggestions. So these are all the other keywords that other shoppers have typed in that relate to the one that you just typed in. So we've got, you know, daily planner, which is what we just typed in, daily planner journal, daily planner 2021 for women, and just kind of goes down the line of the different variations that real people are actually searching Amazon for. It's also going to show before keyword suggestions, so keywords that have words that come before what you've typed in. So, you know, we typed in daily planner, it's showing us agenda 21, 2021 daily planner for women, and it's going to show you some additional Amazon suggestions that are all related to that main keyword that you've typed in. So that is super duper helpful. This alone saves quite a bit of time to just give you all of these suggestions all at once. Now, another great thing here, again, you can download all of the results. And here you go, you've got all of your keywords here. All right, so how do the Self-Publishing Titans Chrome extensions compare to other similar tools available? So first, let's take a look at DS Amazon Quick View. This is the extension that's probably going to be the most similar to Self-Publishing Titans keyword research SEO tool. So you can see here, DS Amazon Quick View, it's got the bestsellers rank, it's got the ranking in the first category that it's showing up for and ranking for, the ASIN. There are a couple of paid features that you can get, such as price history. I don't even actually know what this KDP history is, but it is available for you if you want to pay for it. So you can see that the Self-Publishing Titans Chrome extension is a little bit more comprehensive. It's got that top bar that shows the number of the results, the average price, average reviews, average bestseller rank. It does provide that keyword niche score, which some people might find helpful. And you can download data from each page separately. All right, now let's take a look at AMZ, or AMZ for my American friends, Suggestion Expander. And that's going to be probably the free tool that's the most similar to the Self-Publishing Titans. I keep mixing up all of these all the names of these extensions. This is going to be the one that's similar to the other Self-Publishing Titans extension that we were looking at. So again, let's just type in Daily Planner. Make sure that's turned on. Okay, there we go. So you can see it's definitely got a very similar feel to the Self-Publishing Titans extension. So both extensions show the primary keywords and the keywords before. This one shows keywords after, but I noticed with the Self-Publishing Titans extension, it seems to show those, the ones after in the other category. So I don't think those have been left out there. Now, AMZ only allows downloads on their paid plan. So unlike the Self-Publishing Titans extension, you're not going to be able to download these for free. You do need to upgrade to the paid plan. And the paid plan is $9.97 a month or $99.97 a year. And it also includes hundreds of additional keywords and also links to searches in three different Amazon stores, Google Trends, and a word analysis. So you do get some additional information with the paid version of AMS Suggestion Expander. So those are the two free tools that I think most resemble the Self-Publishing Titans Chrome extension. So as far as similar paid tools, probably my favorite is going to be Publisher Rocket. That's what I've been using for a couple of years now. Publisher Rocket is going to give you basically all the information that we just looked at with these free extensions. But you're going to get things like search volume, competition, help with category selection, and stuff like that too. So that's what this one is here. There's also, of course, Helium 10, there's KDP, KD Spy, and a couple of other ones. But this is the kind of tool you're probably going to look to if you want a few additional features that the Self-Publishing Titans Chrome extensions don't include. So overall, I think that the Self-Publishing Titans Chrome extensions are going to be really useful and handy for anyone that's just starting out with keyword research and wants to find a way to streamline the process a little bit and save some time on their keyword research. I think that over time, the longer and longer you're doing this, you might want to consider investing in a paid tool that's going to give you some additional features like search volume and help you with things like category selection and so on. But I think in the beginning, when you're first starting out, I think that these extensions are great free tools just to help get you going and save some time. If you want to learn more about Self-Publishing Titans and their Chrome extensions with a couple of video tutorials, you can check out their YouTube channel, which I have linked to below. If you want to learn more about how you can generate passive income selling journals, planners, notebooks, and more on the Kindle Direct Publishing platform, then be sure to download my free guide linked in the description below, 3 steps to publishing your first low content book in less than a day. And you can also join my free Facebook group, Low Content Profits, also linked in the description below. Check out these videos next for some more keyword research tutorials for the Kindle Direct Publishing platform. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.